The shop started June 2018, the YouTube channel November 2018. We're at over 120,000 subscribers, and around 6 years later, I've collected a lot of mosts.
Like, ano yung most controversial video namin?
The rabbit!
And what's the most cringe thing I've ever done for YouTube? Sino yung hater that I appreciate the most? But before all of that, the most improved segment of our channel has to be our iconic ad, which was conceptualized, produced, and executed by the staff. These are the people you trust with your computers.
Marami na kaming natulungan.
Dati, sad and depressed ako. But now, I found the love of my life.
Dati, aimless and walang purpose ang life ko. But now, I'm a world-class Zumba instructor.
So, web developer ako and content creator for a YouTube channel. And ngayon, ganun pa rin ako pero activated na yung Windows ko.
Kaya ako naghahanap ka ng legit, mura, at original software.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
Our most controversial video, or the video na pinakakinabaan ako before we released it that we might get in trouble in the sense na magka-online mob na magagalit sa amin, is the video where we explicitly criticized Yuga Tech. So Yuga Tech, very influential tech channel, they came out with an article for a recommended build at a certain budget. And the parts that they chose were really bad, like hindi talaga value for money. And then, if you dug a bit deeper, it was because sponsored by SM yung article and all of the components came from SM. So yung dahilan siguro but napili yung mga items na yon had nothing to do with what was good for the viewer, for the person reading the article. It was for other reasons, what was good for the sponsor, maybe. I don't know. But it was really bad advice. Oh, grabe. But it's the first time that we called out anyone, whether a YouTube channel or a media organization, specifically by name. Filipinos in particular are not confrontational. And even if you're in the right, in the sense that tama naman yung sinasabi mo, ikaw pa rin masisisi. Because we don't like people who call out other people, who make people lose face. So I really struggled whether to release that video, but I really couldn't help it because I really thought it was bad advice. There's a portion of that video where the suggestions are just so terrible that on camera, I found myself laughing. Like, tumatawa talaga ako, hindi unscripted. I just felt the suggestions were so bad na napalol talaga ako. Lol, IRL. The ram... the ram... I'm not even... And I included that in the video. I was the one who edited that video also. And people did criticize me online na, okay, tama ka naman, pero hindi mo dapat pinagtawanan. But I felt that was a genuine reaction. Yung nga, hindi yun scripted. Of course, I knew the points that I wanted to make. But as I was expressing them, genuine yung laughter na yun. Because the advice was just so bad. And I've never talked about this before in any other videos or posts. But after that video came out, we had people messaging us who new sort of behind the scenes of some of the things that happened there. And it was very interesting, the points of view, the experiences that they shared. Di ko na lang ikukwento on camera because yun nga, I wasn't and I'm not after the controversy. I just wanted to help people with an alternate build for that budget. To sort of suggest that this suggestion by this channel, this media organization is not that great. I have a different suggestion. It might not be the best, but I think it's definitely better than that first suggestion. Most cringe part about doing YouTube is the host, me. Ang hirap panoorin yung mga luma kong videos. To be honest, kahit yung mga bagong videos when I'm editing them, I really don't like looking at myself on camera. I feel it's very awkward. False modesty aside, I know that I can explain technical concepts in an easy to understand, basic friendly manner. Walang problema yon. But I also know na hindi naman ako ganun ka-charismatic. Yung tipong gusto mong panoorin kahit walang mga gimmicks sa background, kahit walang RGB. I need extra editing, extra pizzazz to make the video easy to watch. Yung content maganda, yung host hindi masyado. I have improved a little bit, but really in the earlier videos, like itong third video namin.
I've watched so many that I've noticed the secret that she's kept.
Sobrang bagal ko magsalita. Parang takot ako sa camera. And so I have gotten better, a bit looser, a bit freer. What's up, internet? But it's something that really doesn't go away. But watching myself and knowing that this is going to be seen by hopefully thousands of people, cringe pa rin siya. Our most clickbait title comes from an early video, Close the Shop Forever. Tapos yung forever, yung four pa, hindi yung tunay na word na forever.
So we are going to close. We are closing the shop.
But as with many of our titles, clickbait nga siya, but the kernel of truth is there. Sinara talaga namin yung shop na yon, but we opened up in another location. So kumbaga, yung tinutukoy ng shop doon, not Hardware Sugar in general, just that particular location. So clickbait nga siya in the sense that you're wondering ano nangyari, nagsara na ba yung business. Misfortune sells, whether it's in public, whether online, whether on YouTube. And I get it. Ako din, napapaklik ako sa mga ganyan na, oy, hindi umasenso, bumagsak yung negosyo. There's appeal there because you kind of want to figure out what went wrong. Hindi naman na natutuwa ka na may nagkamali, may nabigo sa pag-ibig or sa negosyo or sa buhay. But you're just really curious what happened. And that title kind of plays on that emotion. But I feel hindi naman talaga siya super clickbait. It gets your attention, but there is truth there. Sinara talaga namin yung store na yon to move to a better, larger location, which I actually still miss, yung Giho location namin. The most fun video for me, the first one being the 60k subscriber special video, so that's where I react to mean comments. You speak like drunk Baron Geisler na lasing.
Ano? Ano?
I actually miss the mean comments. Of course, we still get them. Di mo maiiwasan yan sa YouTube, online. But we got a lot more of them nung maliit pa yung channel. 10,000 subs, 5,000 subs, 20,000. So it was really interesting when I did that 60,000 subscriber video. Ang dami talaga mga batikos about anything, about the way I present. Okay, content and the talks. Pero mas okay kung iba siguro ang nagsasalita. The way I blink or don't blink, the way I use English wrongly. It's really kind of funny. Because if you know me in real life, entire life people have been saying Englishero ako, konyo ako, amboy, whatever. But when I start doing videos online, it's like, oh, your English sucks, grabe yung Filipino accent niya. So if you ever post something online and people criticize you, it's just like water off a duck's back. That is the nature of the internet. You don't know what you're talking about. I'm lol at your blog. I'm just lol. Someone will always criticize you. And actually, I miss that. I miss the kind of rough and tumble comments na kung ano talagang masasabi. Kasi natatawa ako. And I think that really comes across in the 60,000 subscriber video where I'm reacting to the comments live. Actually, lahat ng pwedeng gawin sa PC, alam ko. In the sense that tuloy-tuloy yung shoot na yon, ako lang mag-isa. Tapos every time I mean comment, I would take a shot from our sponsor for that video, Don Papa Rum. I think the old subscribers remember this video because we gave away also Don Papa Rum. Excellent rum. I had a great time shooting that video. Also, it was my birthday, I think, or close to my birthday when I shot that. So, ang saya lang ng vibes. And the second most fun video for me to do was an older video, sort of like the types of PC buyers in the Philippines. And then the third one there was the critic.
Kasing build video na to. Di pa marunong maglagay ng RAM. Mali na nga yung GPU. Bottleneck tawag dyan, pari.
Puro lang reklamo about a build. It can never be a perfect build. There's always something wrong. Bottleneck ng bottleneck. So really amped up the character. I mean, it's an exaggeration of the kind of person that you would see in online forums.
May how to buy PC parts for beginners. Di naman ako beginner.
In real life, that's the exact opposite of how we want to treat our builds and our customers. Yes, we want to explain why we're doing builds like that, but we don't want to be that kind of guy.
Ano klaseng PC shop to? The Verge Philippines!
Video that most made me feel like a YouTuber, and there are several common suspects for this when a brand like ASUS sends you an expensive item, for example, the ROG PG48UQ, great monitor, Or when a brand sends you abroad to look at their factory and you make content about it. I mean, these are experiences na hindi mangyayari if we didn't have a YouTube channel with a substantial following. And those were great, but the number one video that made me feel na, ooh, tech YouTuber, is a video where I had to do work. This video is useful. I think it's a topic that hasn't been developed by a lot of people. A lot of people just figure that yung UPS parang cellphone battery. So kung fully charged, maaasahan ko na 2 days worth of use. Or sa UPS, at least 15 minutes worth of use bago matay. It's a little known fact that yun nga, non-linear yung discharge. So there is no set or rough time. So just the investigation of that question, which UPS is right for you, what can you expect, testing it on my own system, all of those things are elements that I associate with the bigger YouTube channels. Yes, with more budget, with more time, with more people that can do the work. But it was also proof na kaya rin namin. Hardware Sugar relatively is a smaller channel. But with good ideas, we can find topics na hindi pa masyado na pag-usapan and we can contribute to that. Hindi lang kami kumukopya sa iba. Most important video is a tie. Of course, the video that a lot of people initially subscribe to.
Experience, here are the top 5 PC building mistakes based on what we've seen.
Yung kwento doon, we had actually released that video and it got a decent number of views relative to what we were used to at the time. Pero wala naman nangyari. And then like a month later, I checked the stats, biglang, ooh, 500 views. Next day, 1,000, 2,000. Paakyat ng paakyat. It took the algorithm a long time to figure out that, oh, this might be something people are interested in. But once it started sending people to that video, padami ng padami yung mga views at yung mga subscribers. That was the video that put the channel on the map. Yun nga, hindi kami overnight success. We had a lot of videos prior to that video. So, as with most things in life, I find it's like a slow burn. You have to put in the work, you have to put in the time, you have to put in the effort before all of the things that you do are noticed. So we got a substantial subscriber base from that one video, but the video that's really sustaining our subscriber base for the last 2 years or so is this video, yung PC Masterclass, which is an evolution of the Biblica series. Pinagsama namin lahat to information, added new information. So in that one video, which is over an hour, 20 minutes long, sobrang nahirapan si Ryan to edit that. Everything is there. All of the basic PC components, CPU, GPU, PSU, storage, RAM, motherboard, cooling, whether AIO or air-based, casing, lahat yun nandun sa PC Masterclass video na yun. A large chunk of our new subscribers, even though 2 years old na yung video na yun, comes from that video. And since it already is 2 years old, we are planning an updated PC Masterclass video sometime around this year. We just need to find the time to write it, shoot it, and edit it. The hater that I appreciate the most. I do like getting mean comments. They make me laugh. But this guy, I have to hand it to you, sobrang consistent mo. We're at around 120,000 subscribers now. Nung 60,000 subscriber video, nabanggit rin kita. Can't believed na 26.5 subs ka, tapos para kang amateur sa PC. Because you were one of the guys criticizing us for water cooling. Kung tama yung pagkatanda ko, I said something like, in one of the earlier videos, the shop doesn't do customized water cooling because I'm afraid to get into that. That takes a lot of work and expertise. And you're like, andali-dali lang mag-custom water cooling. I don't know why you guys are making a big deal out of it.
Kulang ka bata.
Actually, I'm close to 40 now, and on a personal note, I'm filming this on my birthday. So, malapit-lapit na ako sa 40 anyos, and it feels good to have somebody call me bata.
Sir, I do not know how old you are, pero kalma lang.
But in fairness to you, you're still at it. You're still watching our videos. So, Otaku Gaijin, thank you for watching our videos. I have no idea who you are, but you've been there from very early on. Up to now, you're still at it, and I appreciate the amount of attention you're giving us. I have no idea if you're a curmudgeon-y old guy, but thank you so much for watching us and for commenting. I really enjoyed your viewership of the channel.
Paminsan, may nagtatanong kung may kilala ba kaming computer shop na trusted, yung hindi ka lolokohin. Actually, meron. Kami. Full-service PC store ang Hardware Sugar. Nagbabenta kami ng PC components. Nagbebenta rin kami ng fully assembled rigs. We clean computers. Kasama na rin yung excellent cable management namin and CPU cooler repasting sa cleaning. We also clean and repaste GPUs. Nasa Makati yung physical store namin and you can also buy from our site www.hwsugar.ph na 100% palaging up-to-date yung inventory dun. Kung in-stock yung item sa amin, available yun sa site. We also ship nationwide. Thanks for watching and maybe one of these days, magkita tayo sa shop.